According to Dr. Ruth Namazi, a pediatric hematologist at Mulago Hospital, the facility currently receives and treats about 100 children with sickle cells in a day.
We estimate that about 500,000 people are affected with sickle cell disease in Uganda, and that this number is expected to double by the year 2030 if we don't do anything about it.
She is, however, worried of the cases doubling over the years.
We see an estimated about 100 children every day coming in to seek care. About 50% have a painful crisis or have a fever, and about 50% come in for routine care. On the sickle cell ward, ward 16A, is the busiest ward in pediatrics, with over 60 patients with sickle cell disease admitted every day.
Sickle cell disease is an inherited blood disorder that causes sickle-shaped red blood cells. These sometimes stick together, blocking blood flow and oxygen from reaching all parts of the body. People with sickle cell disease can experience pain, also known as pain crisis, anemia, infection, and other serious health problems that may require emergency treatment at hospitals.
But key to this is what we call disease-modifying treatment, which does not cure the disease, but reduces the severity. And the drug that we currently use in Uganda is called hydroxyurea. It is licensed by the National Drug Authority. We have the confidence from our clinical trials that it is safe. It changes the lives of people with sickle cell disease. It reduces painful crises. It reduces need for blood transfusion. It reduces acute chest syndrome. It makes their lives better.
Dr. Namazi attributes this increase in cases to failure by the prospective parents to test for sickle cell disease. She confirms that the disease can be treated if diagnosed at an early stage, advising all parents with children with the disease to seek urgent treatment.
But I call upon the caretakers to bring their children for comprehensive care, for proper follow-up. Also for the patients to be encouraged to live positively. It is possible for patients with sickle cell disease to live a normal life.
We have sickle cell groups in Uganda, and we have faculty and students of Makerere University, and we have all come here to engage, to discuss, to talk about one of the most important and prevalent health problems in this country, sickle cell disease.
The call comes at a time when the Ministry of Health is doubling efforts in high-burden areas such as Lango, Acholi, Busoga, Teso, Busia, Central and Wugisu sub-regions, especially in Budama and Bugweri areas. Story compiled by Karuka Suja Adi for the news.